Welcome. Welcome, YouTubers. In this video, I'm going to make an attempt to restore this PowerDome EX unit. Keeping my fingers crossed, let's move on. You know, in a sense, I've opened this thing. I had to get in it and clean it out, make sure that there wasn't any livestock in there. And basically this was how I found it in my storage, with the same wire tied up and attached to it. And here's what inside of the unit looks like. Right, so here we have what I would assume is the inverter. This is the pump, a speaker for the radio. I think we will be cutting this pump because, well, there's a back of it that is broken off, so it's not really pumping anything, so we just might take that out of the unit. So yeah, here we are with this thing in its glory, running out of space as to how to put these things. I'm going to start off by taking the thing for the pump. Let's do a little bit more rearranging there. Alright, this thing is damaged, really serves no purpose inside here, so we'll be looking to take this out. Let's see. Okay. So we have a bit of connection. It's kind of holding. Okay, so that hose goes on to the pusher unit there. Okay. Just a bad man and do that to it. That should be that. Come around here and pull out this. There's a small space, so I don't see this going back up through this space here. Appear to be clamp on. Don't think it's screw on. I think it's still clamp on. So hey, guess what happened? Bad man took again. We're done with that. Have a motor that's attached to this. And we're gonna bad up that too. So. Alright. So away with you. So we'll have that remove, taken out. Now, spin back this thing around and have a look at the front. So here we have pressure gauge. Alright. I think we're going to leave that for looks. I'm gonna have to take that off. But I will. Okay, so we'll have that out. We have 2 wires left inside here. Okay. As I said, this is a piece of 4 mm. What's this cable called again? Vocal cord, 4 mm vocal cord, which we'll be using to connect to the battery and also to connect to the unit as well. Alright, so we need this vocal cord to be able to go inside. We will try to remove some of this here. Now everybody is going to have their own way of doing this thing. This thing is not a like a training course. So if anyone choose to take on something like this, please do it at your own risk. But in no way I'm an expert to this. I just have this thing lying around and think that it might make a good video. And one, also, I just might get some use out of this unit. We don't need this ground wire, so we're going to do away with that. Let's see if we can kind of sleeve it back. Okay. I don't know if I said it, but I've had this thing for a while, way back in the day, that I used to fool around with it. So I have 2 holes here on the side where we are going to pass our wire through. Get on the inside. And we need to make a connection. So I have 2 sets of wires in here. Okay, fine. So this is our main. We need to make a connection to our main. And what color wire should we be using for our main? We have blue and we have brown. Well, we will be going with the brown wire. There we go. We will be trying to wrap it on right here. So we need a little bit more. Look. Let's see, we do this. We take it in there. Bam. Like that. Bring it back around. Fur. Okay, cool. Sucker. There you go. You up there, you down there. Yeah. received to her mother. Now, I don't want to make any sort of permanent connection at this time because I just might decide to put back a battery in this unit and have it set up the right way. I'm prepared to do this sort of temporary sort of connection and to have this thing. Just find out also if it is actually working. I'm not quite sure, you know, if this thing is working or not. So we're going to bind them up good and proper with some electrical tape. Again, no way am I a expert at this sort of thing. I'm sort of doing this because I actually got hold of two batteries and just decided to try to see if this unit is actually working. So I have that one there. We'll come over here, take it that this one here is the negative. We wrap that onto the positive, I believe. To wrap that on. I think we're right. Hey, there might be some magic smoke if this doesn't go the way it's supposed to go. Okay. Which is more than one, they all came here and converge. Okay, so I'm going to need something to be able to bond all of this together. I'm trying to use this to clamp these guys together. Watch it, do it yourself, DIY. Massive bolt. Massive. Okay. On the power hose. Okay, now we're stripping this guy. Working with sharp objects in your hands. Okay, so this is us. Looking apart. Trouble.
is inside. Is sticking out. Anything else? This part of the board is cut and sharp. To it. Sorry guys for the sort of messy job. Last thing is the tape, just to make sure that's us. Alright, so remember I cut off the wires for the pump. Down there. We're going to be taping those up for now. I think I might have plans for those wires, so I'll put a bit of tape on there for now. So secure. Alright. So that's that. This is where things are. So this thing is short of some screws. I think there's only like two or three in the bottom. But so for now, I'm just gonna tighten this. Just for now. So we can move on to the next stitch.
Well, right, so this is going to be the battery box. Can you believe it? Yeah, this thing is going to get a battery box. So, do that. As long as this, come out in here, you can put the opposite side and connection. Let's turn this around. Alright, let's get on with it. Tension restraint. He's a big boy. Alright. Okay. And with that, we can put this guy here in. Wow.
Okay. Battery box. Or something. Okay. All right, that's better. Away. It's important. We have a clamp. A positive, negative. Cool. Awesome. So the word is, I think I want to do something a little bit different. Guys, don't hold it against me. In a sense, it's kind of like my show. I know the writing, I don't feel like doing the writing right now. So, this is how I'm going to make the connections. I heard somewhere where it said it's not good to knock these battery terminals. Ready? So that's what I'm going to go with for my connection. I know it's not the way. There's a fuse in the front. Should I unplug the fuse? Something. This thing is out. Yay, look at
we got light.